Asante.
Thank you.
Good morning.
Good morning.
This is Deborah.
This is Marlon.
Deborah is married to me, I believe.
Emmanuel is married to me.
Are you sure?
I don't know.
So we are very honored to be here. We are very happy and thank you for inviting us.
Let us dance the dance of glad hospitality. This is my family. My dad was a pastor, but now he's retired. But they are still using him when they want him to do some service. And due to life that we live with my family, I didn't like to be a pastor. This is because our home is like a public house. My parents received many different kind of people. Disabilities peoples, poor peoples, women and children who runs out from their husband's home. So every time, every meal we ate with people, we didn't have any private in our home. We didn't eat any food as a family. And I don't remember how many times we slept on the floor as a children so that we can leave our beds and mattress to our guests. So when my parents asked me to go and start the theological study, I said no.
In the contrary, my mom is too much. So last summer, Deborah had Abna, or Abna is 2 years now. So I took them home because they haven't been home to visit our parents, so they get their blessings. And my mom and my dad find a goat. They slaughter a goat for us, especially for Deborah, because of this baby. It's our tradition, if someone has a baby, you prepare something like a goat. So we were so excited. The meat is in the house.
Not him, but me.
At least, because she's a meat eater. So we ate one meal, like the evening meal. Then the following morning, she shared all the meat with the community. She gave to everybody because people don't eat meat all the time. That was like kind of special food, and they knew that we were home and maybe we brought some gifts. So people who don't get that kind of meat, they come and show up and would say, "Mama, we thought this should be for the family." Say, "Yeah, but what do you do if somebody knocks and asks for food?" Say, "But this is of a kind." Say, "How do you eat if somebody's hungry? That is too much."
It is our tradition. In Tanzania, it is our tradition to receive the strangers, to receive the guests. We believe that guests are the angels. Although we are not receiving them because maybe they are angels, but it is our tradition to receive the guests. We don't stop to receive the guests. And when you receive them, when you receive the stranger, you have to stop everything that you are doing and then you concentrate for your guests. If you were at the farm, you have to stop doing farming things and go home, prepare food. You cancel all your schedule and you are just focusing for your guest.
So on this image, we have the kids. Some years ago, one of our family family friend family. One of our family friends from Norway visited us in Tanzania. So this is, if I can go back. This is our, their kid. Here we go. So this kid is very new. She's a stranger in this community. But other kids grabbed her and they were just walking her on the street, showing her the farms and the places. And she was like, home. They did not speak the same language and they were all playing. They were just playing and going around. And they were all doing all fun stuff. They trusted each other and we went to take this image. It's like, wow, this rock is not even strong. It is tied up on the tree, but who cares? They just trust each other and they are into one thing, one common thing that connected them. A church, she was just surrounded by everybody. Everybody was a friend. They never questioned. They never asked what language she spoke. They were just into their common things. Even cows trusted her. That is radical. To get to a place where you feel home, just home, even if you don't show like them, you don't look like them, you don't speak the same language, you are completely a stranger. That is something that we can learn from this. So, in our case, this was a very big visitation. What did you do? I was the chief, sitting waiting for the ball.
After receiving our guests, we have to do something special for them. We have to cook something special for them. Did you show them our regular meal?
This is our regular meal.
Oh, it didn't. This is our regular meal, and we eat it like 95%. This is ugali, and we call it mlenda.
Mlenda is like soup. It's made of some
vegetables. So we eat this all the time. But when you get some guest in your home, you have to prepare something good for them. It doesn't matter if you have that. It doesn't matter if you have money, but you have to do something. You have to, because we know that our friend, they are coming, they informing us for maybe what, 3 months that they are coming. So we started prepared for a long time, taking our money, paying some money. So we have to take this because we have a guest.
How much did you get paid that time?
For that time, I was paid at like $50.
$50 a month. So our income, our salaries total in a month was like $100 in a month. So but that is our common food, but you cannot want the guest, even a stranger, to eat your regular food.
Yeah.
That is, you cannot do it.
No.
Whether you have or you don't, that does not count. You have to go ask for neighbors. You have to go borrow a cow, a goat, or a chicken, or something. You have to do something. You have to do something special.
And we are not feeling like, oh, this is hard. Oh, no, but we are here to do that. And we are not thinking maybe this is too much. No, it's like our tradition is coming from our heart that we have to do this, and we are happy.
And some of you who have been to Tanzania, I'm not sure you have eaten something like this. Otherwise, if you stay enough and get into the families, then they might introduce you to that. But if you are just there for 1-2 weeks, you will not see this. You will just see something special. Maybe a chicken?
This is our... She's Deborah, and this is our chicken. So she went to the chicken house to take the chicken so that we can kill and they can eat. And not even the chicken, also the goat. We buy the goat for them. And they were so, you people, you don't have money. And sometimes they want to buy soda, they want to buy something so that they can eat. So no, you cannot buy something in our home. You are in our home, so we have to do something for you.
If you come in a Tanzanian house, whether you eat somewhere, you are full or not, you will have to eat. Because food is, they won't even ask you whether you are hungry or not, because that is very rude. They will just stop everything, because it's like a state of emergency or something. Stop everything and cook. And you cannot be in a hurry to avoid cooking. You have to stay and eat. After you eat, you can go. So then you have to prepare something special, which is rice and beans or meat and banana.
Yeah, this is
potatoes.
Potatoes. We cook chips. We boil potatoes. It's...
That is rare. We don't eat that often.
No.
In my life, maybe that is 1% of me. Maybe 5% of the borough.
Yeah, maybe 5% of me.
Otherwise, 99% is Ugali. So, we have a say that Mgeni Njoo Mwenyeji Apone. I could not translate it, but it is like, come a stranger or come a guest to serve a resident, like to serve us, because we are sure when we have a guest, the meal, the peace, everything changes. And life becomes, special. The kids are happy. They know, wow, today we have a new dad. You see, this is our son, Aunt Mercy. He does not eat this very often. So he's like waiting for it to be ready. It's like, yay, today is special. So come the guest to save the family.
Yeah.
And sometimes we really, really share from nothing. And this is the picture of Hadzabe. We visited Hadzabe some years ago. And Hadzabe, some of you know about Hadzabe. They live in the forest. They depend in fruits, honey, wild meat, all that. They are now learning to plant and do small-scale agriculture, but otherwise they depend on hunting. They don't have houses. They move around. So when we send a messenger to inform them that we were coming, they had prepared us a house. So this is kind of a house that they built for us. And we got there. It was just a hut made of grasses. For it was a group of choirs, so like third of us, and this cannot take all of us. We went with some tents, but the special, so like the leaders of the group had to stay in that house, which has nothing, just the dust, and we put some grass on the floor and we sleep. People who don't have the houses themselves, but could think of putting us in that house and hunt some meat for us to eat. That was really something. That was something.
So we have an African philosophy which said, I am because you are. I am because we are. You cannot live alone. You cannot be a human alone. I am human because you are here, and we are helping each other. We are communicate, and no matter different cultures we have, no matter different religion we have, no matter different faith we have, but all we are together in the community. All we are together. We connect each other. Our different culture, our different religion or faith does not do anything to our relationship.
Yeah, so in Ubuntu, being a human in our community really overrides everything. It overrides everything. For example, if Ogotana was in Singida, there's a funeral in one of the houses here, people in the entire Ogotana will come, regardless of their religion, regardless of their anything. As long as you heard that somebody died, they all come. Invited, not invited, whether they are Muslims, whether they are Christian, and if the one who passed away is a Christian and they have a service in the church, people just come in. They don't say, I'm not a Christian, they just come in, they don't. That is not the religion thing, it's a social community thing.
If you don't come, you are in trouble.
Yeah, if you don't come, really,
you are in trouble.
People will not get you. They will not understand.
You have to pay something. You have to pay.
You might be penalized.
Yeah.
You might be put in the set of elders to be questioned. What are you trying to be? So no matter whether you have or you don't, no matter what tribe are you, as long as something happens, even if it's a wedding. So now with the modern life, people try to invite some people to go to a wedding and, you know, some are not invited. Who cares? A wedding is a social event. People show up. What will you do? They just show up because you are not a human. Otherwise, there are other humans. That's what we believe. We are not, because we are because you are. So in one example, we have one example. This is Kenya. It happened in 2015. In Kenya, they are fighting Al-Shabaab. You know Al-Shabaab. These are bad guys. They are Islam extremists. They kill people. They have killed many people. And one time there was a bus full of almost 100 people. And they attacked the bus. They yelled with their
guns
that, okay, if you are a Christian here, if you are a Muslim here, if you are a Christian here, they wanted to separate them according to their religion. So they killed the Christians. They have done that before. Well, people did not know what was their point. But in this case, because these passengers knew they were being divided to be killed, some to be killed and some to be let go, the Muslims decided to become the shields. They said, they even took, they wear their things, they put to Christian women to really mix up. And they said, we are not divided by religion. We are all Kenyans.
If kill you want to kill us, yeah.
Or let us go.
Yeah.
And they did not kill them. They let them go. That is radical. To think of somebody who you know, really, he will kill you. And you offer your life because of your neighbor. That is radical. So, in general?
In general, we think that our radical hospitality is still in the community level. And maybe we have not done enough. We have some limit in the community level. And we see that maybe there is a gap. There is a gap. We didn't do it more. We didn't think it more. Just we think in our community, in our surrounding, I can say this.
We haven't gone beyond the border.
Yeah, beyond border, beyond maybe beyond our I can say maybe as you hear, you are thinking beyond of. You are thinking about Tanzania, you are thinking about Sudan, you are thinking about. So for us it's, no, it's just we are not done enough, I think.
Why? Because all Americans
are rich.
money from us. No, you are rich. I'm kidding. So, in our perspective, we really think the outside is rich.
Yeah.
Outside is able. Outside have everything. So before we even come here, we thought everybody's a millionaire. Until we came here, then we started to realize and to understand even those contributions, your kindness, your missionaries you send, that it's not the outcome of extra money, like taking from the tree. It's really people who give, not from extra, but they give from a very tight budget. A very tight budget. And Deborah can say, we will not say a specific thing, but Deborah can share her experience of being here in these few months.
I have almost 8 months since I have been here. And according to Emmanuel, he has no plan about us. I can say this, I'm sorry. He didn't know what we can eat when we were rich here. He didn't know how we can live. But you people here, you are so kind. That I see. We are full welcomed. We are full embraced. We are full, what can I say?
Supported.
We are full supported. There are many of people who do not sleep thinking about us, thinking what to do so that they can support us, thinking what they can do to raise money for us. So for me, this is so right hospitality.
Yeah, and Deborah talks about that all the time.
All the time we have talked this, and I engage in the different group in the church. I'm quilting with some women in our Savior Lutheran Church. It is the first time it was a surprise to me. We received some kind of that
quilts
in our home, but we didn't know that who made it. But it was from old women. They didn't even see. All the time they asked me to, can you put the take my needle and put the string in the needle. And some of them, they are just shaking their heads and making that quilt for me. It is so, so radical hospitality. And they did this for other people, not for them, but for other people. For me, it is so. This is radical hospitality.
So we hate this now. And yet we love it. I love this now. But I hate it when I have to clean my car before 6 a.m. to drive to the to Minneapolis. Anyway, we there's no word to explain how we feel home here. Otherwise, we could be strangers, strangers. But we really feel very, very home, very embraced. In all ways, and we can see some things that we wish our church could learn back in Tanzania. Some things are very little. Even like you have in your churches, prayers for specific congregations, prayers for it's. I wish those congregations knew that you are praying for them. You are concerned about Tanzania. However, we still think our observation, of course, is yours is more of from
division.
Family, individual to international. We don't see much of the community engagement. You do much diacon preaching, you know, but I don't know if it works in your system, in your culture. I don't see how it can work to have that community the way we do. Ours is individual community. Yours is like you jump from individual to international, and you don't have much here. But I don't know how, if it's applicable in your system. So, yeah. So let us finish with.
Let us read this 1 Kings 13, 7 to 16, but always is like we took two verses, 11 and 12. Can we read all together?
So Elijah.
As she was going together, he called, and bringing these to his prayer.
The widow.
As surely as the Lord your God lives, she replied, I have a heavenly prayer, only a handful of flour in the jar, and a little olive oil in the jar. I gather a few sticks to take home, and make a meal for myself and my son.
That is radical.
This is, I know you know this story of Elijah and this kind of the
don't woman. Preach.
Yeah, I know. I am a pastor.
She's a pastor.
So what I want to say here is this woman is pouring everything he has. He didn't take from some from what she has, but she take everything from what she has. And she didn't know about tomorrow. But according to this story, it's like he welcomes the angel without knowing. His life was full of food and drink and everything. Maybe from this story, we can ask ourselves, what is the radical hospitality? What is the radical hospitality? Is it real to do something because I have something? It is real to do something because I have much, or you do something because you have to do it, you have to save. Or you do something you have, is you save people, you save someone, you save and maybe this is the definition of, I don't know if the definition of his explanation of radical hospitality to save.
How does it look to you? How does the radical hospitality look to you? Thank you.